Anastasi. Yeah, pisces is good for almost anything. If you're not sure what to say, and you don't know Greek, if someone says something to you, say a pisces. So, whether they're wishing you something good or not, say a pisces. But Kali Anastasi, this is when we start to say, have a blessed resurrection. So, I'll just say it one more time. Kali Anastasi.
Pisces.
Today, and actually we started Holy Week yesterday. Lazarus Saturday is really the beginning of our Holy Week. And of course Lazarus is a prefiguring of what's to come with Christ. But today we're talking about the triumphal entrance of Christ into Jerusalem. And so he went, so before he made his entrance into Jerusalem, he went to the home of Lazarus, Mary, and Martha. And of course, Lazarus had been raised a week earlier. This was an amazing event, and Jesus was there having supper. So Martha was serving, which fits the story of Martha and Mary. The sisters maintain their thinking and their thought process. But Mary does something interesting. She takes costly nard. Nard is like an ointment. It's a perfumed ointment. And she put it on Christ, his feet, and her tears, and she wiped it with her hair, and she anointed Christ. Now Judas Iscariot, was upset about this. He was the treasurer of the money for all the apostles, so he kept the money all the time. He was upset of it because the nard that was used cost 300 denarii. And does anyone know how much a denarii was, more or less? How long did you have to work to earn a denarii? One day. So that means it was the better part of a year's salary to buy this nard that was used to anoint Christ. And Christ said, he didn't stop her. Christ said, it is good that she does this because she's preparing me for my death. So what were the death rituals of the Jews? And actually ancient Christianity, they're the same. When a person dies, if a woman dies, they take her to her home, and all the women of the temple or the church would come together, and they would wash her body, and they would anoint her with nard and other spices. If a man died, the same thing would happen. They'd take him to his home, he would be washed by the men of the community, and he would be anointed. So this was a real thing that happened, and it was a real prefiguring of his death, that he got anointed. It's also interesting because when Christ came down from the cross, which we'll be celebrating later in the week, or remembering later in the week, what did they do with him? It was just a little bit before sundown. What happened with Christ? So they took him down, and they had very little time left, so they hurriedly put him in the tomb. And they did not have the time to do all the things that should have been done, but Christ had already been anointed. God plans for everything. And so even though the women later on were upset that ultimately found him risen, he received everything that a normal practicing Jew would have received. He was prepared and he was ready. Christ's answer when Judas said he was upset about the money being used for this purpose instead of being used for the poor, but that wasn't his motive. We're told he just wanted to keep that money because he had been little by little pilfering along the way, and he wanted that money. So we have here examples of a whole bunch of things. And what was Jesus' reply when he said, we should have sold that nard and given it to the poor? Right, you always have the poor with you, but you don't always have me. Does that mean that we shouldn't take care of the poor? No, of course not. But at that point, they had a specific thing that they needed to do. Truly, I think that you and I should be constantly submitting to God and constantly asking, what is you want me to do today? Because on that day, they were called, Mary was called to anoint Christ. That she didn't even know what she was doing. She just felt compelled to do this, and Christ explained it. You and I, if we want to live a Christian life, we need to constantly be seeking what God wants. Sometimes that makes sense, sometimes it doesn't make as much sense, but we need to have that peace in our heart and do what Christ tells us to do that day. Some days you may be called to visit people in hospitals. The next day, someone appears that needs lunch and you provide it. Just listen. So here on this jubilant entrance into Jerusalem, Christ has already been prepared for his death. And yet the people are waving palm leaves. The people don't know what's coming. Even the apostles did not know what's coming. But they walked in faith of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And ultimately, they knew why they did the things they did and why things happened the way they happened. So for each of us, we need to listen to God. As Jesus Christ, of course, he was fully man and fully God. He did have an advantage on us. He knew from his divinity what needed to happen. You and I have a piece of Christ in us. Right? We're created in his image. Christ is in you, and you are in Christ. That means that you're closer to God than you know. And you have to be cleaning out the soot to make sure that pathway between you and God is open. So when you're taking, when we're doing the great entrance, which will happen shortly, I want you to take the palms that you've been given and wave them. Where this is all about Jerusalem today, the joy of what is coming that no one knows. We've read the end of the book, so we know, but they didn't on that day. So I guess if I ask you to take anything home this week, I want you to take some of the joy of today to get you through the sadness and sorrow of the rest of this week. And I want you, which we should always do during Lent, to evaluate, how do I draw closer to God? What do I need to do? What do I need to stop doing? How can I hear him so that every day I'm his bondservant? Would you please rise?